There will be no announcement. We just start to play when I tell you. There's no announcement. We're up first. Okay?
Why? That guy was like talking crap about his brother that died in the car.
Thank you. parents, friends and family members, trustees, and officers of the Board of Education, Superintendent Mark Belang and Student Council President Emily Haydu, and most importantly, the members of the class of 2023, welcome to the 97th commencement ceremony for Portage Central High School. As always, I would like to start tonight's celebration by thanking the most incredible team of teachers I have ever known, our teachers. Now please join us in the singing of our national anthem. So please stand, gentlemen, remove your hats, and join the chamber singers as they lead us in the singing of the Star Spangled Banner, directed by Randy Simons Miller.
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
If you happen to be at the Mustang Rideout this morning, thank you for your patience with us in that extreme heat. 20 years ago, when I was far younger in this role, I forgot the very last Mustang Rideout speaker, current math teacher and football coach Mike Freeland. Well, I did it again this morning and forgot incoming Student Council President and incredible human being, Elise Martinson. I am grateful for her patience too, and I would like to welcome her here tonight. Elise.
Thanks again for that very great
You're welcome. Friends, family, and most importantly, to the class of 2023, my name is Elise Martinson, and it is an honor to speak before you today on one of the greatest milestones of your youth, high school graduation. When you exited the halls of Portage Central for the last time just over a week ago, things were different. As my classmates and I sat in class last Wednesday morning, I overheard someone say, "What are we gonna do now that they're gone?" And as I have reflected on this statement, I've been able to recognize while also feel the impact you have left on myself and the underclassmen as a whole. For all of us underclassmen, you have always been there. You have paved the way and then helped us down said path. The experiences you have shared helped shape us into who we are and ultimately guided us throughout all stages of childhood. I recognize that you have been there every step of the way as my class grew up, doing so as well. To start at the beginning, your class was there on our first day of school. You were there as we were the timid kindergartners at the bus stop, but you graciously taught us how to ride the bus, of course making sure we sat in the front or didn't sit in the back until it was our turn, or you sat with us and probably told us how awesome the toys in the kindergarten room would be. Throughout elementary school, you were there to be our book buddies, and you taught us how to hang out with the older kids through games such as Gaga at extra recess. You were role models as elementary safeties, you experienced the field trips and likely bragged about them, which only made us more excited, and gradually you developed into the independent big kids we admired and wished to be.
As we entered middle school as awkward sixth graders, you were the leaders that guided us through the hallways, helped us locate rooms on our schedule, and always opened our lockers when we couldn't remember which direction to spin it. You were experts on how to decorate a locker or which trapper keeper we should or shouldn't get. You showed perseverance through changes, such as the transition from Musical.ly to TikTok, and taught us the importance of being in with the trends, yet never ceasing to humble us when we needed it most, ensuring that we always knew our place. Finally, throughout high school, you've continued to be there for us. You lended a helping hand, whether it was offering us a ride home from activities before we could drive, or gifting us your summer reading books and study sets from the year before. You've been our passing partners in practices and our biggest rivals in spirited activities. You've exemplified leadership in both activity and athletic captain roles. You've shown us how to be super fans with a fierce battle cry, and your class has set the standard for what being a Mustang encapsulates. Just as you did when we were kindergartners, you've used your experience to comfort us as we faced our own teenage hardships throughout the last 3 years. And lucky for us, you've become some of our best friends. Through all stages of childhood, your class has been the ones who went before us, the ones who led us, and most impactfully, the ones who looked out for us. You've taught us how to be better leaders, you've passed down tradition, you've exemplified resilience, and you've fostered connections that underclassmen are lucky to have. Your class leaves behind a precedent of what it means to care, and undoubtedly, there are big shoes to fill. As you continue to drive down the path that lies before you, know that all of us will be cheering for you in the rear view. In the next stage of life, may you all continue to look out for each other and care for one another just as you have done for us, knowing that by doing so, you will continue to leave a profound impact on those around you. Congratulations, I and the class of 2024, your own superfans, can't wait to see what all of your futures hold. It is now my pleasure to introduce someone who has represented and led you, your Student Council President, Emily Haydu.
Thank you, and good evening to you all. Being the Student Council President this year has been an incredible honor. I, as well as many of my classmates, could not have imagined the course of our journey throughout high school. As with every high school experience, we all went through ups and downs. But being here today, many of those moments may seem pretty insignificant now. In reality, all of those little moments shaped who we are right now. We would not be the same people without trying to find our crush in the hallway, fighting with our parents about what we're wearing for fall formal, in hindsight, we always should have taken the jacket they offered, or waiting until the last minute to cram for our final exams. We have grown so much since we entered the school as freshmen 4 short years ago. Though as freshmen, senior year felt ages away. Our resilience and flexibility has shown in countless ways. We not only learned from the grades before us, but taught the grades after us what it is truly like to be a Mustang. Graduating is an immense accomplishment alone, but we all learned so much more than just how to write a paper and how to find the angle measurements of a triangle. We are kind, selfless, strong people because of Portage Central and because of one another. Through it all, we each learned about ourselves, which is the most important lesson of them all. Our future is bright, and I know that our impact on the world will be great. If it is the only thing we take away from high school, I hope we all remember what it means to be a Mustang and take it with us as we go our separate ways. Now, it is my honor to introduce Lena Smith with our opening commencement address, From Prologue to Epilogue, Our Story.
Sorry guys, it's a little dusty. Dear fellow graduates, staff, family, and friends, much like a good book, our class is captivating, complex, inspiring, and unique. It's full of ups and downs, twists and turns, revealing a story that has been in progress the past 12 or more years of our lives in education. Pages are filled with priceless memories, friendships, and moments that made us. We've been looking forward to graduating since the day we started elementary school. The 2023 at the end of our IXL math usernames seemed like a date so far away, but here we are. Just like a good book, unlike Of Mice and Men or Great Expectations, high school has been an exhilarating journey. It has been an adventure that we have shared with one another. We have made lasting friendships, conquered a pandemic, discovered new passions, and created memories together that will stay with us for the rest of our lives. Throughout our formative years, we grew up with the number 2023 entrenched in our brains. That's so far away, we thought. That is, until we set foot through the doors of Portage Central High School on the first day of our senior year. We began to reminisce about days of no homework, daydream of nights spent driving with our best friends to get ice cream. Life was simple and graduation was really still in the distance. And then we blinked. And here we are, walking across a stage in a cap and gown, reaching for a diploma we've worked tirelessly for over the last 4 years. How did that happen? When did June of 2023 actually get here? As we walked through the doors on our first day of freshman year, we were eager to discover what the next 4 years would hold. The opportunities seemed endless. Whether you were interested in forensics, sports, student council, or theater, we all had goals we'd hoped to achieve and lessons to learn, like walking it through the right door into the stairwell, which was a hard lesson for some of us to learn. Each experience added to our story, and the pages started to get full, making it a richer and more meaningful narrative. But, much like a good book, our years at Portage Central High School must come to an end. We turn the final page, close the cover, and say goodbye to this chapter of our lives. We got used to what was familiar. On Mondays, we watched PCTV in our fourth hour, listened to music between passing periods every Friday, roamed the hallways every day for 4 years, and now we step out into the unknown. Just as we eagerly anticipate the next book in a series, we also look forward to this next chapter in our lives. We have the opportunity to write our own story, to create our own path, and make a difference in the world. As we close this chapter in our book, let us remember the lessons we have learned, the friendships we have made, and the everlasting memories we have created. Let us take these experiences with us as we embark on the next chapter of our lives. And let us continue to write a unique story that is full of adventure, success, and most importantly, happiness. Congratulations, class of 2023. I wish you all luck on the beginning of your next chapter. Thank you.
Next, I am honored to introduce our student performance performing When We Were Young. Here are Carter Barnes and Andrew Klepser.
Everybody loves the things you do, from the way you talk to the way you move. And everybody here is watching you, 'cause you feel like home. You're like a dream come true. But if by chance you're here alone, can I have a moment before I go? 'Cause I've been by myself all night long, hoping you're someone I used to know. You look like a movie, you sound like a song. My God, this reminds me of when we were young. Let me photograph you in this light, in case it is the last time that we might be exactly like we were before we realized we were sad of getting old and made us restless. It was just like a movie. It was just like a song. I was so scared to face my fears.
cause nobody told me that you would be here. And I swear you moved overseas, that's what you said when you left me. You still look like a movie, you still sound like a song. My God, this reminds me of when we were young.
Let me photograph you in this light, in case it is the last time that we might be exactly like we were before we realized we were sad of getting old and made us restless.
It was just like a movie, it was just like a song.
When we to admit that everything just takes me back to when you were there, to when you were there.
And a part of me keeps holding on just in case it hasn't gone. I guess I still care. Do you still care?
It was just like a movie,
it was just like a song.
My God, this reminds me
of when we were young.
Time that we might be exactly like we were before we realized we were sad of getting old and made us restless. Oh, I'm so mad I'm getting old, it makes me reckless. It was just like a movie,
it was just like a song when we were young.
Family and friends, honored school board members and colleagues, we're coming here together as a community to celebrate the incredible accomplishments of this graduating class of Portage Central High School. But we are also here to honor some wonderful seniors who likely are not here yet tonight. Members of our women's tennis team competing for a state title up in Midland today and tomorrow. We had a special graduation for them and for their families on Wednesday, and it was wonderful. Some may have made it back in time and might be with us here tonight, and others are still up there and are watching through our YouTube live stream. And all of them together created this special message for us.
Once upon a younger year, when all our shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day you'll leave this world behind, so live a life you will remember. Father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights that never die. My father told me. My
Two, halfway through the awarding of our diplomas, we will pause and show a brief video of those same student athletes receiving their diplomas on Wednesday. And I would ask that you cheer for them just as loudly as you cheer for everyone who's here tonight. Because the truth is, you, as a class of 2023, you have brought us back. Back to our traditions of excellence, back to striving for the best, back to pushing past the boundaries to create a culture of high expectations ethically and academically in our activities, in our athletics, back to improving who we are today so we can improve our community tomorrow. You have led by example, showing your integrity and your high standards for how we are to treat one another, and that example has refiltered throughout our entire community. For example, you have demonstrated your high expectations for yourself and your teammates through our three-time state championship forensics teams. Congratulations to them. As well as to our state championship archery team. Let's celebrate them as well. You have exhibited your leadership as you walk through the halls and as your Mustang superfans led an intense and super loud student section on Friday nights. Indeed, you have left your handprints all over this place called Portage Central. In contrast to the incredible things you've accomplished, I am wrong a lot. Elise and all of you saw that this morning. For full disclosure, I have a long history of being completely wrong about all kinds of things, especially the very best of ideas. To start with, when I was in high school, I had decided definitively never to be a teacher. Really, the primary reason I became one was, well, a girl. To be clear, I am not suggesting to any of you who want to date, that should be the main reason you choose a career path. Still, more than 30 years later, that has worked out pretty darn well for me. Also, truth be told, when I was a brand new teacher, I did not want to come to Portage Central. And wow, was I wrong about that too. There could have been no better place for me to spend a lifetime than here in our Mustang community. Students and families have given me thousandfold more than I could ever give in return. So it's little wonder then that when great colleagues have shared an awesome idea with me and I was completely wrong about it, they just ignored me and did it anyway. Our teacher, Jill Wiskowski, did exactly that. Many, many times. And we all continue to be the better for it. More than 20 years ago, Jill wanted to find a way to show that Portage Central belonged to all of us, that we all had a stake in our community's success. And she wanted to show that with paint, which made me really nervous. It sounded messy. And again, I was wrong. This is a 20-year-old snapshot of the South Hall of the old Portage Central High School. Each year, our freshmen would come in, paint their hands, and leave their mark. For 4 years, they would walk by who they had been, giving them the opportunity to consider who they were becoming and who they wanted to be. And then when we moved into the new Portage Central High School 12 years ago, Jill and her students did it again, making sure that every student who helped open our new doors could leave a part of themselves with us, hanging over the Welcome Center for all of us to see every single day. And then, a few years later, student leaders again made the visual commitment that supported Portage Central is made from and through all of us. We have all walked through the Mustang Commons and under this mural 1,000 times. But maybe you didn't look carefully at one part of it, the trail. Can you see something up there? Yeah, those are footprints. Those seniors of 2015 went to our elementary schools and engaged with kindergartners and fifth graders and all in between to send the message that they too are part of the Mustang community. A number of those former elementary students now walk under this mural as Mustangs every day, seeing who they were and helping them to consider who they want to be next. This year, you've done it all again. Through the leadership of your student council, you reasserted our traditions, gathering together on a beautiful day to leave your mark, to show that you are not only part of our community, but that you have contributed to and built on our community. You have continued the leadership that stretches back more than 100 years now. And now, in a very real way, you will be leaving your mark here to encourage others in the years ahead to do the same. You have, without question, helped move us onward. And we are all here tonight to be very, very grateful. Thank you for everything you have accomplished, and God bless. It is now my pleasure to introduce you, Ms. Kimberly Larson, trustee for the Portage Public Schools Board of Education.
As I stand here right now representing the Portage Public Schools Board of Education, I look at this class with pride. I hope you also feel that pride. You have accomplished a major goal today, graduating and earning your diploma. This is the culmination of 4 years of learning, of writing essays, of doing projects, and taking tests. And you've done it. I have one request as you start your life after high school. Do not stop learning. Some of you are going to universities and colleges. Take this time to explore and see what interests you and what will get you excited about going to work each day. For those of you going into the workforce, keep learning there also. Find things that expand your knowledge. Explore new interests. If you're taking a gap year, use this time to learn something fun while you prepare for entering college next year. No matter what, please keep learning something new. And to everyone here in the Portage Central High School class of 2023, on behalf of the Board of Education, congratulations and well done.
For our next performance, this is You Will Be Found by Pasek and Paul, performed by the Portage Central Chamber Singers under the direction of Randy Simons Miller.
Have you ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? Like you could fall and no one would hear? So let that lonely feeling wash away, 'cause maybe there's a reason to believe you'll be okay. 'Cause when you don't feel strong enough to stand, you can reach out your hand. And oh, someone will come running,
and I know
they'll take you home.
Even when the dark comes crashing through, when you need a friend to carry you, and when you're broken on the ground, you will be found. So let the sun come streaming in, 'cause you'll reach up and you'll rise again. Lift your head and look around. You will be found. You will be found. You
Members of the Board of Education and Superintendent Mark Belang, I present to you Portage Central High School Class of 2023. These students have completed the State of Michigan graduation requirements as well as the more rigorous standards established for graduation by our Portage Public Schools Board of Education. I am really glad and grateful to introduce Mr. Mark Belang.
Thank you, Mr. Albertus, and to the staff at Central High School for all that you've done over these last 4 years to prepare this class for this day. Congratulations, class of 2023. I'm honored to accept you as the 97th class to graduate from Portage Central High School. It's also my pleasure to welcome your family, friends, and staff, some of the many people who supported you over the years, and join you this evening to celebrate this important milestone. We're here this evening not only to issue your diplomas, but also to celebrate a significant milestone marking the conclusion of a big chapter of your life. And with that, to recognize that an equally significant chapter is about to unfold for you. It's one of life's bittersweet moments. Commencement speakers often use their time to give advice to the graduates. I'm not going to do that this evening. Instead, I'm dipping into the well of knowledge filled by some of our youngest students. A few weeks ago, I asked some second graders at Lake Center Elementary School what super important advice they had for this year's graduates. As you might imagine, they had some interesting things to say. So several students gave this advice for those of you going on to college. Rowan said this: be kind to the teachers in college. They give you your grades. Caden had this to say: when you go to college, work hard and stay focused. Emily likes to think ahead. She said, when you're about to go to college and you live in an apartment, you want to think about where you want to live. In the country in Alabama, in Portage, or in Florida. You have to decide where you want to live before you go out into the world. Okay, and then there's this from Morgan. Make sure you know what job you want so you don't have to go back through college and get a second diploma. Reed's advice went in a different direction. He said, if you fill people's buckets, they will be nice to you. And then Quinn, he created a list. And here are five things off of that list. Do the right thing for other people. Spend money on the things you need. Be kind to animals. Put on sunscreen. And don't eat too much candy. So Paisley also had a list, but she added a number of varying exclamation points, I think indicating where her priorities were. So the first one, and this one had no exclamation point, only a period. Don't spend money on stuff you don't need. Second one had one exclamation point. Keep your house clean so you can find your stuff. And this one deserved two exclamation points. Spend your money wisely. And finally, the last one was three exclamation points and a heart emoji. Make sure you get an easy job for yourself. Gabriel had just one piece of advice. Do your laundry every day. Okay, and this came from Grayson. If you ever get a pet bunny and you're planting carrots, make sure it won't eat them. And then there's another read in class that says this: remember, if you get a job, never yell at your boss or you'll get fired. And then Willow builds on that just a little bit. When you get a job, you have to show up on time with a smile. And there's this from Jacob: always be kind and treat people how you want to be treated. And finally, from Calvin, go to college. And then he adds, when you're done, you can work at Meijer or at Big B or at Walmart. So I certainly hope that's not the case for you, but I want to thank Mr. Brizendine and his second grade class at Lake Center for all of this advice. And with that, it is now my honor and pleasure to officially accept you, the graduating class of 2023, the 97th to graduate from Portage Central High School, and present you to the Portage Public Schools Board of Education, who very shortly will be awarding you your diplomas. Congratulations, best wishes, and spend some time listening to second graders. Thank you.
Next, I am honored to introduce our second student commencement address, To Begin Again, by Jason Krozik.
Good evening. Welcome, students, faculty, friends, and families gathered here to celebrate the Portage Central High School class of 2023. As the youngest child in a family with sisters who are 5, 13, and 15 years older than me, I've been in the business of listening to graduation speeches for quite some time now. And as I reflect on those events, I recall my mixed emotions. There was boredom. Like many kids, I never sat still, and staying quiet was just not a strength of mine. There was fear. I was never ready to see my sisters leave, and I knew I would eventually find myself as the only child at home. There was admiration. Even at 5 years old, I knew it was something special to be wearing that cap and gown. Most of all, however, there was anticipation. I saw three of my biggest inspirations receiving diplomas, and I wanted to be in that exact same position. I'm sure this anticipation rings true for many of you as well. 8 years ago, I received a shirt on my last day of fifth grade that had 2023 in big, bold font. And when I saw those numbers, I chuckled because that year had absolutely no meaning to me at the time. It just seemed so far away. Now, I chuckle because it has been 8 years, and although I have undergone immense change, I still feel like that same little kid. I still haven't processed that this is the year 2023 that seemed impossibly far away. And I'm now standing at our graduation, speaking to all of you, living the reality of some of our wildest dreams. This is the year we understand that it's time to go. The year we sadly say goodbye to longtime classmates and educators, and the year we will begin to forge our own paths as we enter a new world. I can thank my younger self and his firm belief that graduation acted as a one-way door between childhood and adulthood for this difficulty to comprehend the fact that we graduate today. As a kid, graduating seniors seemed so old, so confident, so sure of their next steps. So it's been difficult for me to traverse this year with lots of uncertainty about what my future will look like. I always felt like I would never grow up. But it turns out that the infinite supply of time to decide on the perfect course for each of our futures just was not so infinite. At 18 years old, I still have no idea what I want to be when I grow up. But thankfully, I'm not the only one in this stadium searching for a place in this world. Entering this year, we paid special attention to each of our lasts as high school students. Whether it was the last first day, last Friday night under the lights, last prom we danced at, or last exam we ever took, we made sure to note that it was an experience we may never have again and etched it into our memories so that maybe it would never be forgotten. Fortunately, we can avoid dwelling on these many lasts by finding peace in the opportunities for many firsts in our near futures. For me, these firsts are incredibly daunting, yet exciting. My first night living away from home, for example, will probably be filled with tears, and I can only hope that my first newfound friend at college will provide me with some comfort at that time. These many experiences to come are unpredictable, but I hope each of you walks away from this graduation ready to embrace that imperfection and uncertainty on your horizon. Each of our lives is headed in a new direction, and we can only do our best to take control of our futures, even if we may not know what we want that future to look like. Contrary to the beliefs of my younger self, this moment does not act as the permanent end to our childhood. And as we stand on the other side of the door, I know that we will always be able to step right back into our childhood where it will accept us with open arms. We are just as free to make new mistakes and learn from them. There may be times where we become lost or overwhelmed in the labyrinth of our futures, but we can always recover by taking naps or watching nostalgic Disney movies. We will fall down, and we will stand back up, even with scraped and bruised knees. We have all we need to step into the daylight of our future. And as we watch our lives begin again, I am confident when I say we are ready for it. Thank you.
For our last student performance of the night, it is my honor to introduce Mackenzie Schramm performing Vienna.
Thank you.
child. You're so ambitious for a juvenile, but then you feel so smart. Tell me why you're still so afraid. Where's the fire? What's the hurry about? You better cool it off before you burn it out. You've got so much to do and only so many hours in a day. Yeah. But you know that when the truth is told, that you can get what you want or you can just get old. You're gonna kick off before you even get halfway through. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you? Slow down, you're doing fine. You can't be everything you wanna be before your time. Although it's so romantic on the borderline tonight, tonight. Too bad, but it's the life you lead. You're so ahead of yourself that you forgot what you need. Though you can see when you're wrong, you know you can't always see when you're right. You're right. You've got your passion, you've got your pride, but don't you know that only fools are satisfied? Dream on, but don't imagine they'll all come true. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you? Child, and take the phone off the hook and disappear for a while. It's all right, you can't afford to lose a day or two. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you? And you know that when the truth is told, that you can get what you want, or you can just get old. You're gonna kick off before you even get halfway through. Ooh, why don't you realize Vienna waits for you? When will you realize Vienna waits for you?
Now is the moment you've been waiting for, seniors, the awarding of your diplomas. I would ask for our seniors on our right and in that first row, please stand. Please join Assistant Principals Tama Salisbury and Asia Kaler and step forward to receive what you have earned, your high school diplomas from our school board members, Terry Noveria, Emily Crawford, Kimberly Larson, and Bo Snyder.
Anna Rakowitz. Claire Arkenstall. Sarah Colarossi. Alyssa Eberhard. Morgan Ryder. Caitlin Armstrong. Aaron Brandstrom. Allison Hiltz. Khadidra Epps. Alexa Hodgson. Michael McKella. TJ Whitley Pitts. Keegan Davis. Cameron Kuiper. Kendall Lumen. McKenna Johnson. Danielle Hall Kernu. Rory Horan. Tyson Mosier. Ryan Sunder. Hold on. Leslie Ramirez. Rebecca Nacken. Ella Miller. Tyler Bronkema. Lorene Darwesh. Natalie Green. Cameron Cole. Matthew Hahn. Evan Cooper. Tanner Grindall. Josh Allen. Easton Hayward. Samantha Swafford. Madeline Monarch. Cece Gillick. Brooke Tiller. Caroline Miller. Sloan Can. Jordan Butler. Marina Klein. Will Cassidy. Michael Holmes. Amanda Mack. Isabel Felch. Nate Warner. Tabia Chop. Victoria Ryan. Andrew Klepser. Carter Barnes. Brinica Thrash. Riley Vandevelde. Lauren Fulton. Vanessa Larkin. Mackenzie Hallam. Lena Smith. Jesse Smith. Clayton Bacon. JJ Jamal. Afan Siddiqui. Deacon Heckert. Macy Pung. Aman Singh. Zachary Stewart. Ahmad DC. Zane Akil. Ben Hunter. Peter Lewis. Valentino DeCroce. Mia Baker. Oh. Sophia Lekashetti. Hannah Ejaz. Shanze Dar. Abigail Noggle. Megan Farrell. Caitlin Patton. Caitlin Walsh. Lucy Cheatham. Megan Baird. Akila Jayatalaka. Tharini Sadanaiga. Malena Fiol Viver. Lucia Garza. Kaya Dreiselka. Leonie Lottermoser. Sydney Wartner. Gracie Sweetay. Morgan Rierick. Katie Schultz. Blake Page. Parker Damasca. Esteban Martinez Peralta. Carlos Rangel. Elijah Simmering. Owen Sue. Zachary Koenig. Ravi Patel. Christopher Curtis. Joshua Minier. Trenton Phillips. Wyatt Smith. Isaac Stacklewitz. Charlie Fry. Aislinn Johnson. Shane Dong. April Haskett. Riley Lum. Alana Thomas. Polina Redko. Andrew Ely. Johnny Cleesby. Peyton Conway. Gavin Lee. Ben Rickers. Drew Williams. Allison Dietzel. Julius R.K. Kennedy Gardner. Kayla Goldsberry. Connor Vanderwall. Bradley Kelper. Ben Hinsey. Brandon Theobald. Ethan Kinney. Aaron Perg. Hannah Clary. Lexi Cox. Elena Benaway. Olivia Clotta. Keenan Millar. Landon Carpenter. Andrew Kuehl. Joseph Bucher. Tristan Spital. Andrew Durian. Evan Vasquez. Matthew Devine. Bruno Dirksen. Jacob Earl. Blythe Jernigan. Taylor Fetterman. Rosalina Wessner. Tay Hilliard. Alyssa Ramudo. Soraya Mulakaila. Alexander Breyer. Nathaniel Kraus. Caitlin Hogue. Ian Jewett. Ezralyn D'Souza. Nolan Higgins. Tyler Swartzfisher. Hannah Cowgill. Juno Cronin. Alexis Lassiter. Chandler Sims. Jacob Naninga. Andrea Smith. Ava Broker. Victoria Dwyer. Morgan Yates. Lauren Norg. Emerson Curtis. William Darrow. Ryan Yaculo. Isaac Dune.
Next, we'd like to pause and recognize those student athletes who are competing for a tennis state championship with this video of them receiving their diplomas at our special ceremony on Wednesday. I would ask that you cheer for them too, just as you have done so incredibly well for all of our graduates, as some of these students are still watching, our student athletes are watching through our live stream. Nora Van Sweden. Malia Lakey. Mindy Huang. Breland Gutshaw. Anna Dinsmore. Sophie Dana. Simmer Bhatia. Genevieve Bauer. And Deshaina Batala. Next, I would ask the seniors on my left and in that first row, please stand and join Assistant Principals Tamma Salisbury and Asia Kaler and step forward to receive what you have earned, your high school diplomas.
Emily Haydu. Sophia Dana. Paisley Siebers. Jason Krozik. Alexa Moulton. Caroline Elliott. Emily Wyatt. Olivia Eby. Hannah Huff. Jessamine Pike. Miles Leonard. Brooke Bennett. Ryan Ernest. Zoe Wellum. Andrew Dinges. Beckett Celine. Jack Pastula. Landon Bauer. Evan Erb. Ethan Erb. Hayden Parker. Aiden Reams. Joshua Gormley. Aiden Farrell. Jackson Honecke. Nate Long. Tyler Lynch. Caleb Stiluka. Bradshaw Yulman. Kari Thorolson. Benjamin Myers. Jacob Yaculo. Olivia Pearson. Madeline Crampton. Elijah Littell Sibley. Lillian Gearing. Lauren Klein. Madison Digby. Aubrey Borenstein. Peyton Seeberger. Paige Zach. Madeline Weiss. Lexi Pavlowski. Libby Johnson. Sky Hansen. Alexis Weber. Abigail Reifenberg. Carly Clear. Ziana Virgil. Gabriella Lynn. Cecilia Lynn. Riley Anstadt. Noah Kaskayar. Hannah Nagel. Abigail Liddell.
Congratulations.
Noah Nelson. Clay Wazalewski. Nicholas Lynn. Harsimer Sohi. Rachel Milu. Lilu Clegg. Matthew Nordheis. Kira Jewett. Pietro Katsago. Carter Maynard. Olivia Reyna. Benny Rumbambiza. Emma McKay. Ipsa Wagle. Woo! Gwendolyn Summerfield. Alexandra Springman. May Bradford. Jensen Lucht. Jenna Japp. Cameron Fruhoff. Sophia McLeod. Olivia Still. Garrett Sharp. Ian Baker. Vasco Sanchez Moreno. Alexander Porco. Tobin Wheatfelt. Landon Bush. Braden Lancaster. Charles Anderson. Ben Thomas. Ethan Tiller. Malia Lakey. Nora Van Sweden. Catherine Kinney. Camille Shepherd. Emily Sturgis. Layla Wallace. Alicia Wiles Austin. Emma Surratt. Jaden Vanderbloomer. Gabneet Singh. Lucas Loschutz. Stephen Perangeli. Colin Walpole. Yeah! Amara Klein. Yeah! Aubrey Fennessy. Yeah! Peter McCarron. Jaden Amy. Zayden Amick. Carson Westbrook. Taylor Cannon. Jenna Shear. Caleb Sage. Samuel Thompson. Whoops. Michael Rarig. Hayden Ballard. Rexton Steele.
Hello, Daniel Sturdy. Hello.
Daniel Sturdy. Samuel Kirby. Tori Moberg. Mark Warden. Ethan Jones. Aiden Milks. Braden Keller. Ava Rierich. Matthew Curtis. Colton Doremus. Carson Horton. Cole Lindsley. Hope Lim. Jada Blake. Timothy Zhang. Levi Wagner. Trinity Faverty. Evelyn Gifford. Aaliyah Kensler. Bentley Schreiber. Oliver Steele. Nathan Mills. Haley Loso. Ava Shoemaker. William Barber. Rochin Lee. Amaya Chowdhury. Ryan Chenoweth. Sir Connor Larson. Gavin Vogtberg. Lucas Campbell. Stephen Barnes. Maverick Murray.
All right, here you go.
Jacob Clark. Brianna Vermeulen. Yeah.
Simmer Bhatia. Breelyn Gutshall. Genevieve Bauer. Deshna Batala. Fayaz Razi. Selena Zhu. Samadhi Atanayaka. Melinda Hong. Will Vomastic. Alexander Evans. Layla Erke. Jillian Skursky. Mackenzie Schramm. Ava Moyle. Brooklyn Swafford Wyatt. Caitlin Anderson. Nathan Kennedy. Paul Schoenrock. Manuel D'Alessio. Ayan Effendi. Jordan Fear. Kaylee Bullheis. Marcus Williams.
We, the teachers and staff at this deeply human place called Portage Central, we hope that you have learned some lessons about life and learning here. We hope that you have hardened your skin just a little bit, but softened your heart. We pray that we have given you attention and focus, and also an understanding that certain things you just have to let go of. We believe that we have strengthened your future, while hoping you have also learned from our past. If you have done all of those things, then we have been successful. So at this very moment, we are going to be asking you to please move the tassel from the right side of your mortarboard to your left. And with that, I am incredibly proud to present to you the Portage Central High School School Graduate Class. Congratulations.